Hey guys, what's going on? Jeff here from Films at Home, and today we're going to review a new 4K title from Lionsgate. This is Ghost in the Shell, the original anime on 4K Blu-ray. Hey everyone, so thanks for coming back to the channel today for this review. As I mentioned, we're going to take a look at Ghost in the Shell. This is the original anime classic, and it is being remastered here in 4K for the first time in the US. I did read up on the fact that there is also a Japanese 4K disc, which is a different transfer apparently. So I'm just reviewing this one, not doing a comparison. I don't have the other disc to compare to. So we'll just be talking about the US disc here, but that is just a note that not the first time it's ever been done in 4K, but the first time it's available in the US. So I'm gonna be upfront about this review right off the bat, and I'm gonna tell you that I am not the biggest fan of anime by any means, but I can certainly appreciate good animated movies, and I do love hand-drawn animated movies especially. I think they look really nice, so I have a nice appreciation for that, but I know nothing about Ghost in the Shell. I'd never seen it before, and I know nothing about the story in this anime. All I know is what came from the Scarlett Johansson one, which I saw and reviewed a long time ago on 4K, but I don't know anything about this. So I know the base storyline, but I don't know any of the history behind this. And the reason I say this is because this is probably my least favorite 4K disc that I have ever reviewed. And I know that's gonna ruffle some feathers because this has an absolutely huge fan base. It has a cult following. I am just not going to look at the YouTube comments after this. But I have to be truthful with the way I feel about it and the way it looked to my eyes and what I saw. And I've got to tell you, I am really, really unimpressed. So like I said here, Ghost in the Shell, there's some hand-drawn and some computer animation, and it's remastered in 4K. And with hand-drawn animation, you can get a fairly good 4K image. There's a lot of the hand-drawn Disney stuff that's come to 4K that looks really nice. And of course, Toy Story 4, which was actually rendered at 4K, even though it's computer animated, also looks really nice. So like, you can get a really nice 4K animated picture. But my issue with Ghost in the Shell, we'll talk about picture quality first here, is that first of all, there's a lot of variance in the way that this looks. And I guess it's intentional from what I've read, so it's not a knock on the transfer. It's more a knock on the movie itself, the way it was developed, and I guess if it really needed a 4K release, because there's a lot of scenes that are like intentionally fuzzy, intentionally like washed out. The colors on this were totally off to me. It was way too bright. But then there were certain sequences that looked perfectly balanced and gave a great 4K HDR image I was impressed with. And then I'd go off to another scene and there's like this white glow over the whole image, which just kills any real, you know, colors in HDR that would pop. It has this white kind of, like, I don't know how to describe it. It almost looks like somebody was shining a flashlight right at the screen. And then I noticed that, like, it's kind of a theme throughout the movie. There's kind of this glow in certain scenes, which just was really weird, but it was part of the animation style. There's also other sequences that are, like, intentionally blurry and fuzzy to, like, show, like, flashbacks or to make, like, emphasis on a certain scene. It was just a really, really odd image. There are a few striking points where I was like, wow, that's what I was looking for. That looks really good. That red is super bright, looks amazing. And then I'd get to another scene and just be like, I don't know why I'm watching this on 4K. The hand-drawn animation is pretty sharp, but then again, this is, you know, it was kind of jumpy at times, which then makes it a little bit fuzzy. It's hand-drawn, so you're obviously going to have that issue. But it just ultimately didn't feel like a disc or a movie that needed a 4K release. I kept thinking, if I just had this on Blu-ray, I would have been perfectly fine with the way it looked. But I was expecting a next level on 4K, and I just don't think the source really allowed for it. And maybe, you know, that's probably super faithful to the source, which is why people are probably going to comment and, you know, complain about the review. But that's fine. But if the source isn't really that clean an image, then going to 4K doesn't give it much. It really doesn't add much to the experience. I would just buy a Blu-ray disc and be happy with that. So now on the other side of the coin, outside of, you know, picture quality, resolution, the 4K upscale transfer, whatever you want to call it, the transfer from the animation to the 4K, this, you know, you always look at HDR. So this has Dolby Vision HDR. And so immediately when I hear Dolby Vision HDR, I hear animated movies, I expect pop. Like, animation is so colorful. And there are some sequences in this, like I said, which do pop. There's some really cool, like, cyberpunk neon pinks and blues and greens which pop. Sometimes there's a few sequences where, like, there's red signs on buildings, and, like, you know how, like, buildings in a city will have, like, banner signs on them. Like, those looked really clean. I really liked that. But a lot of times I kept running into this super washed out, way too bright image. It's got to be like an artistic choice, but it certainly doesn't do the Dolby Vision any favors. And if anything, that sort of brightness and almost like glow that it has, Dolby Vision makes it worse. The other issue with Dolby Vision, and I did experience this once in a couple of scenes, and then taking the disc out and putting it back in fixed it for some reason, but a lot of people online have complained about the Dolby Vision flickering and having like this flickering light behind the image, which keeps flashing. And I did see that using a Panasonic 4K player on my Hisense TV, which has Dolby Vision. If you turn the Dolby Vision off and you watch an HDR 10, it fixes itself. So it's clearly a Dolby Vision, like some sort of encoding issue. But I mean, that's another reason why I was like, damn, this disc just isn't doing it for me. You can't even watch it in Dolby Vision because it had an issue. It's not a 100% issue across the board, but clearly the Dolby Vision, something with this disc, has problems, because it's been reported across multiple forums. And I've actually had a few viewers email me video of it happening on their set. And so that's why I made this my next review, because I kept hearing about this. I was going to get to this one. Popped it in, had the same issue, was able to resolve it, but like, that's annoying that the disc is having issues. So I'm just like really unimpressed and not happy with the picture quality here. There is a Blu-ray available that's the same 25th anniversary that this is, and it's half the price. It's only 10 bucks versus this being 18. I would just go buy the Blu-ray at this point. I don't think this movie needs a 4K. I think that's my ultimate point, is it doesn't need a 4K disc. The 4K disc did it no favors, and you could easily get away with a solid 1080p Blu-ray and enjoy this movie just as much without paying extra for a 4K disc and expecting something more, which you should. We didn't get it. You just don't get it here, in my opinion. Now on the audio, you have both an English and a Japanese Dolby Atmos track. So if you want to watch it with the English dub, you get Dolby Atmos. If you want to watch it in the native Japanese language, you also get Dolby Atmos. Now, I've read also online that there's some issues with missing songs. I guess the songs in the credit changed in the credits, and possibly one more song throughout the movie was changed in the English dub from the Japanese. So there's some, you know, confusion about that, and why, you know, why they couldn't just unify that across. I'm not a huge, like a massive super fan of this movie, like I said, but that's something to note and definitely like look up and do your research on if that's going to bug you. Apparently it was not fixed on the English dub of this release. But either way, the Atmos track on this is one of the weakest I've ever heard. I really didn't hear much of anything that would make me say wow, or even like, that was pretty nice. Everything was fairly front driven, which sometimes is okay, but it was also weak. I very rarely find myself having to turn up my sound. In fact, many times I usually have to turn it down, but I turned it up here. I heard almost next to no bass. My subwoofer was doing essentially nothing. The dialogue was a little bit muffled and wasn't very loud and clear, and the surround effects were essentially non-existent. And forget about the heights, I wasn't hearing anything there. I know that there is an LPCM 2.0 audio Japanese track on here, so maybe that was what the source was. The Japanese Dolby Atmos interestingly enough, sounds better than the English Dolby Atmos. You probably would watch this in Japanese with subtitles if you're like a super fan, a purist of it. I tried both. I watched with the English dub. I think English dubs are terrible, and in this case, it certainly was.
Is that one-eyed bastard here? Who the hell are you? You dare call our boss that?
You bums obviously don't know me.
Oh, I know you. You're one of Lou's men, the one they say can kick like a mule.
There's no real vigor or emotion behind the people who dubbed the English version. It just doesn't match with the characters' faces, which is interesting. And it was weaker than the Japanese track. The dialogue sounded better in Japanese, even though I don't know what they're saying and I'm reading subtitles. It was more clear. So overall, I mean, picture quality wise, I was disappointed. It has issues with Dolby Vision. I don't really think this warrants a 4K release. It did not impress me. And then when you get to the audio, the Atmos, again, unimpressed. Easily could have just gone with a well-balanced 5-channel track or even a well-balanced 2-channel track and gotten probably a better experience, at least better balance throughout your sound system, and just non-existent low frequency bass, just nothing happening there. I was really left confused. Like, I thought something was broken every time I watched this. I'm watching it and I'm seeing weird things with the visuals. I'm like, what's broken? What happened with my system? Then I'm listening to it and I'm like, what is wrong? Is my subwoofer disconnected? Did my receiver blow something out? Did my speaker blow? And it just kept coming back to this disc just not being that impressive. Now, packaging wise, you get a decent slip cover. It's, you know, it's kind of cool. Apparently there's some issues because they've censored the slip cover, I guess. Some of it was censored, but I don't know what that was all about. Then the inside, you know, the two discs, it comes in the black 4K case. You've got the Blu-ray and the 4K disc. No artwork, but you know, the blue and the pink certainly match up with the colors, the color scheme of this movie. Special features is an audio commentary, accessing section 9, 25 years into the future, a little behind the scenes retrospective, landscapes and dreamscapes, the art and architecture of Ghost in the Shell, which is fairly interesting. And then on the Blu-ray only, there's the making of Ghost in the Shell and the original theatrical trailer. So fairly limited on special features, given it's a 25th anniversary edition, but it's not overly expensive, so not a real issue there, but that's just so you know what there is. And I do want to mention this because I keep forgetting to, but subtitles, you have the English descriptive subtitles, and then English and Spanish. So that's all that's on here, obviously. And then native Japanese language is spoken throughout the Japanese version. So overall, I mean, this is going on my stinker list for 2020 for sure. I just am not impressed with it. And, you know, I really try to be unbiased with these reviews. I'm just telling you like what I see. I tell you guys this all the time in my reviews. Like, I'm not an expert calibrator. I'm not a tech expert. What I am is a collector first and somebody who enjoys the home theater experience. And regardless of what you tell me about the brightness levels on a disc or the way that the soundtrack was calibrated and the different codecs it uses and all that stuff's important, but at the end of the day, how does it look and how does it sound? They could have the best Dolby Vision brightness ever, but if I think it looks like crap and the Dolby Vision disc with much lower brightness levels looks better, that's what I'm gonna go with. Ultimately, it doesn't feel like a movie that needed a 4K release. The Dolby Atmos track does nothing for it, and the special features are fairly limited. So why would I spend the $18 on this 4K if I could get a very good presentation on the standard Blu-ray for $10, get the special features that are included here? It doesn't scream 4K quality to me. Doesn't feel like it needed that 4K transfer. Not every movie needs a 4K, and that's something I don't emphasize enough. And it is probably better than the Blu-ray, but it's just not a great or very impressive 4K disc at all, so I personally wouldn't recommend it. You know, it's ultimately my review. It's not the truth. It's not the spoken word. It's not what you have to live by. It's my opinion. And so please don't take my opinion and trash this, because others may think it's fine, you may think it's fine. You should always check it out for yourself and watch and read multiple reviews. But I just really don't like this one, and I I can't get over it because I tried. I tried to like it. I tried watching it on different displays. I tried playing with settings. Nothing I did made this look good. Whereas a good 4K disc I can put into my display, which is calibrated the way I like it, and it's going to look great. Couldn't do that here, and nothing I did could save this one. So that's it for this review. Thank you for watching. Sorry it was a little negative. I hate being negative because I like to put positive energy out there. I don't like to be a negative person, but sometimes you gotta give a bad review, and that's what this is. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. Check out all the other links down in my description for ways you can support my channel. I appreciate you all watching. I'll be back very soon. I know I gotta get through Hitchcock and Sherlock Holmes and some other 4K stuff, so I'm working on it. Trust me, I'm getting there. So stay tuned for all that and make sure you're subscribed. But otherwise, hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll talk to you guys soon.